Good morning, children. This is the time for your EVS class. Myself, Kavita Shree here. Today, we are going to start the second chapter of EVS, Year to Year. Hope everyone is fit and fine at home and ready for the class. Children, can you identify the picture? Yes, this is an ear. Ear is one of the five sense organs of our body. The five sense organs of our body are eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and skin. How many ears do we have? Yes, we have 2 ears. Ears help us to hear sounds. Children, observe this picture carefully. Here you can see pictures of so many animals. Can we see the ears of all these animals? Look here. Here we can see the picture of a horse, buffalo, mouse, pig, dog, cat. We can see the ears of all these animals. All these animals have 2 ears. Look at this picture. A picture of a duck, a crocodile, and a cock. We cannot see the ears of these animals. So, there are some animals whose ears we can see and some animals whose ears we cannot see. Here is a list of animals with ears that we can see and with ears that we cannot see. A deer, a tiger, buffalo, pig, giraffe, elephant, cat. For all these animals, we can see the ears. And for frog, fish, ant, crow, sparrow, snake, lizard, duck, we cannot see the ears. Children, today we have learned that ears are sense organs that help us to hear sounds. In some animals, we can see the ears, whereas in some animals, we cannot see the ears. After going through the textbook thoroughly, try these questions. First question is, fill in the blanks. A. We have dash sense organs. B. We have dash ears. C. Ears help us to dash. Question number 2. Can we see the ears of all the animals? Number 3. Draw a picture of your ears. Number 4. Write the names of 5 animals whose ears we can see. And the last question is, number 5, write the names of 5 animals whose ears we cannot see. Good morning, children. Welcome to the EVS class. Myself, Kavita Shree here. We are doing the chapter Ear to Ear. Yesterday, you have learned that ear is a sense organ which helps us to hear sounds. We have learned that in some animals we can see the ears, whereas in some animals we cannot see the ears. Today you will learn about the different shapes and position of animal ears. Look at this picture of the cute children. Can you see their ears? Yes. What is the position of our ears on the face? Our ears are located on both sides of the head. In animals, different animals have ears of different size, shape, and position. For example, look at this picture of the elephant. An elephant has very big ears. The shape of the elephant ears is like fans. It is located on both sides of the head. Look at the picture of the rabbit. A rabbit has big ears. The shape of rabbit ears is long and like leaves. Rabbit ears are located on the top of the head. This is a picture of a cow.
A cow has medium-sized ears. The shape of the cow ears is like a leaf, and the position is on both sides of the head. This is a cat. Cats have small ears. The shape of the cat ears is like a triangle, and they are located on the top of the head. In dogs, different breeds of dogs have different type of ears. Some have broad ears, some have leaf-like ears, and some have small triangle-shaped ears. So, we have learned that in animals, the size, shape, and position of the ears is different. Now, try to answer the questions. Question number 1. Name an animal with number A, ear like fans. Part B, ears like leaves. Part C, with ears on top of the head. Part D, an animal with ears on both sides of its head. Question number 2. Draw an animal with triangle shaped ears. Children, complete this assignment and learn the answers with spelling. We will meet tomorrow again. Till then, bye-bye. Good morning, children. Welcome to today's EVS class. Myself, Kavita Shri here. We are doing the chapter Year to Year. In yesterday's class, we have learned that animals have ears of different size and shape. In today's class, we will learn about animals whose ears cannot be seen. Look at this picture. Can you see the ears of these birds? No. But how do birds hear sounds? Birds have ears that cannot be seen. Birds have tiny holes on both sides of their head. These holes are covered with feathers. These holes help the birds to hear the sounds. In lizards and crocodiles also, there are tiny holes on their heads which help them to hear. Frog ears cannot be seen, but they have ear holes located directly behind their eyes. Fish don't have ears that we can see, but they have ear parts inside their heads. They pick up sounds in the water through their bodies and their internal ears. Do insects have ears? Yes. But they don't look like ours. Ears, nor they are found on the head. Ears are found on different parts of the body in different insects. For example, a grasshopper's ears are on the sides of their abdomen under the wings. Ants hear by feeling vibrations in the ground through their feet. How do snakes hear? Snakes have no visible ear, so they don't hear sounds as we do. They have apparatus for hearing located inside their heads attached to their jaw bones, which help them to feel the vibrations of air and ground. So children, today we have learned how the animals whose ears cannot be seen can hear different sounds. Now, try to answer the following questions. First question is, how do birds hear sounds? Second question, fill in the blanks. Part A, lizards and crocodiles hear sounds with the help of dash on their heads. Part B, ear holes of frogs are located behind their dash. Part C, ants feel vibrations through their dash. Part D, a grasshopper's ears are on the sides of their dash. Try these questions and learn the answers with their spellings. That's all for today. Thank you. Good morning, children. Welcome to today's EVS class. Myself, Kavita Shri here. We are doing the chapter Ear to Ear. In our last class, we have learned how animals whose ears cannot be seen can hear the sounds. Today, we are going to learn about animal skin. All of us know that skin is a sense organ which gives us the sense of touch. Skin is the largest organ of our body. It protects our body from germs and dirt. Skin also helps to control our body temperature. In human beings, the skin tone has different tones for different people. It ranges from very light color to dark color, but the skin of a person is of single color. In animals, we see some patterns in their skin. For example, the tiger. Tiger has orange with black stripes on its body. Look at the picture of the zebra. The zebra has black and white stripes on its body. In leopard, the skin has golden yellow and black spots. The skin of the deer is brown in color with white spots on it. Look at the skin of the squirrel. It has gray-brown color with three white stripes which run from head to tail. Why do some animals have patterns on their skin? Some animals have patterns on their skin due to the presence of hairs of different colors on their skin. Now look at these pictures of cow, buffalo, elephant. These animals do not have patterns on their skin. Do you think that these animals do not have hair on their body? No, they also have hairs of single color on their body, which can be seen when we go very near to them. So, children, we have learned that some animals have patterns on their skin due to the presence of hairs of different colors on their body. Now, try to answer the following questions. The first question is, match the animal with the skin pattern. The animals given here are leopard, tiger, deer, and zebra. You have to match it with the skin patterns. The skin patterns are orange with black stripes, black and white stripes, golden yellow and black spots, brown with white spots. The second question is, why do animals have patterns on their skin? So answer these questions and learn the answers with spellings. That's all for today's class. Have a nice day. Good morning, children. Welcome to today's EVS class. Myself, Kavita Shri here. We are doing the second chapter, Ear to Ear. In our last class, you have learned that in some animals, the skin is covered with hairs of different colors, due to which we can see some patterns on their skin. Today, we will learn about bird skin. Bird skin is covered with feathers. Different birds have feathers of different shapes and colors. Look at the picture of the sparrow here. A sparrow has black, brown, and white feathers on its skin, whereas a crow has black feathers on its skin. In a parrot, the feathers are green in color, whereas in a peacock, we can see multicolor feathers. Birds' feathers are light, but they are very strong. What is the use of feathers in birds? Feathers help birds in flying. Feathers also help the birds to keep their body warm. Feathers help to control their body temperature. Feathers protect birds from wind, moisture, and sun. So, children, in today's class, we have come to know that skin of a bird is covered with feathers. Now, try to answer these questions. Question number 1, fill in the blanks. Part A, skin of a bird is covered with dash. Part B, feathers of birds are light and dash. Part C, birds have feathers of different shapes and dash. Part D, birds' body is kept warm with dash. Second question, draw your favorite bird and color it. Write down the answers of these questions and learn the answers with their spelling. That's all in today's class. Thank you. Good morning, children. Welcome to today's EVS class. Myself, Kabita Shri here. We are doing the second chapter, Year to Year. In our last class, you have learnt about bird skin. Bird skin is covered with feathers. Feathers help the birds to fly and also keep their body warm. In today's class, you will learn about babies of animals. Look at the picture of these animals with their babies. You can see the picture of a monkey, elephant, cat, dog, cow, and camel with their babies. Children, observe these pictures carefully. Can you see some similarities in these animals? Yes, you can see the ears of all these animals. All of them have hairs on their body, and these animals give birth to their young ones. The babies drink mother's milk. Such type of animals are called mammals. Mammals are the animals whose ears can be seen and have hairs on their body. Mammals give birth to their young ones. The babies of mammals drink mother's milk. Now, look at the picture of these birds. You can see the picture of a pigeon, hen, peahen, parrot, duck, and ostrich with their eggs. Birds lay eggs. So now, let us discuss the special features of the birds. Birds' ears cannot be seen. They have feathers on their body. Birds lay eggs. When eggs hatch, baby birds come out. These baby birds do not drink mother's milk. There are some other animals also who lay eggs. For example, the reptiles. Snakes, crocodile, lizards, turtle are known as reptiles. Reptiles are the animals who can change their body temperature according to the changes in the environment. Reptile ears cannot be seen. They do not have hairs on their body. Reptiles also lay eggs like the birds. The baby reptiles do not drink mother's milk. Look here, the picture of a frog, toad and salamander. These animals belong to a special group of animals known as amphibians. Amphibians are the animals adapted to live both on land and in water. Amphibian ears cannot be seen. They do not have hairs on their body. Amphibians lay eggs. The baby amphibians do not drink mother's milk. Children, you will learn about special features of all these animals when you go to the higher classes. So, in today's class, you have learnt about babies of the animals. Animals with hair on skin and outer ears give birth to young ones. The babies drink mother's milk. They are called mammals, whereas the birds, reptiles, amphibians lay eggs. Now, try to answer the following questions. Question number 1. Write true or false for the following statements. You have to write true for the correct statement and false for the wrong statement. Part A. Animals with hair on skin and outer ears lay eggs. Part B. Babies of mammals drink mother's milk. Part C. Amphibians can live both on land and water. Part D. Crocodile is a mammal. Part E. Frogs lay eggs. Question number 2. Write 3 differences between mammals and birds. Children, write the answers of these questions and learn the answers with their spellings. That's all for today's class. Thank you. Good morning, children. Welcome to today's EVS class. Myself, Kabita Shri here. We are doing the second chapter, Year to Year. In yesterday's class, you have learnt about mammals and birds. Today, we will learn about some amazing facts about the animals. Look at the picture of a whale here. Whales have several features that are common with mammals, such as they breathe air, they give birth to young ones, the babies feed on mother's milk, and they have body hair. So, whales are mammals, not fish. Look at the picture of the bat here. Bats are also mammals, not birds. Even though bats fly, they are not birds. Bats are mammals. They do not lay eggs but give birth to young ones, and their babies feed on mother's milk. Look at the picture of the dinosaur here. All of us know that dinosaurs are a group of reptiles that lived on the earth millions of years ago, but they no longer exist on earth. They have become extinct. Extinct animals are those animals which are no longer living on earth. Why do some animals become extinct? Animals may become extinct because of changes in climate, competition with other species, a reduced food supply, or a combination of all of these. Here are pictures of some extinct animal like dinosaur, holly mammoth, passenger pigeon, golden toad, dodo, etc. Tiger. Tiger is the national animal of India. But do you know that the population of tiger is becoming less day by day? Such animals that are in danger of becoming extinct in near future are called endangered animals. They are becoming less in number day by day. Here are some examples of endangered species. The one-horned rhinoceros is also an endangered species. We need to protect the natural habitat of these animals to help them to survive so that they do not become extinct in near future. So children, today you have learned about some amazing and interesting facts about animals. Now try to answer these questions. Question number 1. Write true or false for the following statements. Part A. Whale is a mammal. Part B. Bats lay eggs. Part C. Dinosaurs and dodo are extinct animals. Part D. One-horned rhinoceros is an endangered animal. Question number 2. What are endangered animals? Give 5 examples. Question number 3. Why did some animals become extinct? So children, write down the answers of these questions and learn the answers with their spellings. With this, we come to an end of chapter 2. We will start chapter 3 from tomorrow. That's all for today. Bye-bye.